In this video, we will talk about the self-excitability of some cells in our body. Let's get started. Usually, a cell gets excited only when it is stimulated by an external factor, such as mechanical, chemical, or electrical stimulation. However, certain cells have an inbuilt mechanism that generates rhythmic action potential on its own without the involvement of any external stimulation. For example, pacemaker tissues in the heart, most smooth muscle cells, and many neurons in the central nervous system are capable of self-excitation. This capability plays a very important role in these cells. For example, pacemaker tissues produce rhythmic heartbeat. Smooth muscles of the intestine produce rhythmical peristaltic movement. And in CNS, it helps control breathing. Thus, self-excitability plays a very important role in many tissues. Now let's see some basic process that produces spontaneous rhythmic excitation. First of all, the lowest membrane potential in such tissues is minus 60 to minus 70 millivolts. This is higher than the usual minus 90 millivolts that we see in many cells. This way, the potential is already closer to the threshold. Now, at this voltage, not all sodium and calcium channels are closed. Some of them are open, so some sodium and calcium keep diffusing into the cell, even in resting conditions. This entry of positive ions increases membrane voltage. This, in turn, opens more channels, leading to more entry of ions. This way, the voltage keeps increasing. And at the threshold, an action potential is produced. Then, similar to most other cells, the opening of the potassium channel and exit of potassium brings about repolarization. Now, these potassium channels close slowly, so potassium keeps diffusing out even after the repolarization. Earlier, we saw that some sodium and calcium channels are open at the resting membrane potential. The outgoing potassium balances these incoming sodium and calcium to some extent for some time. So next action potential is delayed, despite the open sodium and calcium channels. Eventually, more and more potassium channels close, and also more and more sodium and calcium channels open, as we discussed earlier. This leads to a rise in voltage again, and upon reaching the threshold, the next action potential is produced. This way, the cell keeps generating its own action potential at regular intervals. So, that was all about the self-excitation of cells. Now, let's have a quick summary. Some cells can generate their own action potential without any external stimulation. This property of cells plays an important role in many physiological functions, like regular beating of the heart, peristalsis of the intestine, control of breathing, etc. In such cells, the resting membrane potential is on the higher side, and sodium and calcium ions keep diffusing into the cell, even in resting conditions. This is the main mechanism behind the self-excitability of the cell. That's it for this video. Click here to read the notes on this video at our website. You can also explore our entire physiology animation video library over there. To support my free content creation, first leave a nice comment and then share the video with all your friends and colleagues. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.